We're here at McDonough today with senior wrestler Myles Martin for the second consecutive year. He's the Varsity Sports Network Upper Weight Wrestler of the Year. Myles just completed his senior year. He was, correct me if I'm wrong, 49-1?
Yeah, 46. Yeah, 49-1 this
49-1.
Year.
49-1. He won another MIA title, another Maryland State title, and he capped it all off with a championship at the National Preps Tournament. Myles, just an amazing career, an amazing senior season, and you've been on a great team over the 4 years you've been here. There's a lot of success here at McDonough. You know, a lot of people know about your wrestling success, but a lot of people don't know the effort that you've made to actually come to McDonough. You don't live here. You're not from this area, but you come here and board at the school. But talk about your decision to come here and what your experience has been like over the last 4 years.
I mean, my experience here has been great. McDonough's a great place. It's pretty much my family because I live here pretty much every day of the week, and I never really go home like that. My freshman year, I was, like, really big on going to Blair, number one school in the country,
right,
from Jersey. And the coach was really trying to get me in, and freshman year I didn't have, like, a good time here because I didn't kind of want to be here. But then my dad kind of told me to stick it out and kind of give McDonough a chance. And, like, I'm really glad I did. But like, it's been awesome here. And then sophomore year, I, like, kind of was getting the feel of high school, trying to get the weight right. I had to go up. I wrestled 52 freshman year, weighing, like, 140-something, and I had to kind of get used to that. So, like, once I kind of, like, adjusted, made some adjustments, and I was able to wrestle with those upper guys. And then junior year, I kind of, like, broke out, kind of winning tournaments, getting OW at tournaments, and it's been great. And then senior year, I kind of did the same. And besides all that, like, during the journey coming here, the coaches have been helping me a lot with staying down on the weekends at their house, kind of getting some workout partners in the room to like, push me, because, like, I don't know if you guys knew the opportunity I had to go to the Olympic Training Center for my whole senior year because of workout
right.
partners trying to be the best and trying to, like, be ready to go to, like, Ohio State and kind of jump in the lineup if they need me, just in case, like, Kenny Quartz got hurt or someone else got hurt. So it's been great. So they've been doing their best to make me the best, and I've been trying to represent McDonough as much as I can, like, being in the Dapper Dan, who's number one, going to Fargo, winning that, just kind of putting McDonough on the map, and it's been awesome. So my experience here has been great, and I recommend this school to anyone who's looking to have a good time, academically be challenged on the wrestling mat. We go to a lot of big tournaments. We go to Ironman, Beast, Prep Nationals. A lot of the top schools go to this tournament, so it's great. I loved it here. I'm glad I stuck with it and didn't leave to go to the FTC or go to Blair, because I talked to a lot of those guys, and, like, I don't mean to put Blair down, but they don't really seem like they like it there too much. And
it's more just a wrestling factory,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, well, just a wrestling factor, of course, but, like, when I talk about my experiences here to them, they're like, oh, man, dude, you're so lucky you have McDonough. You have, like, you're able to do the things you guys do. So
right.
I think it's awesome because I kind of take this place for granted, and I love it here. It's going to be rough going to college next year. And teachers not really like McDonough teachers, but these teachers are, like, awesome. They're really flexible. They're lenient. They can help you out with pretty much anything. So, and I feel like college is going to be, like, you're on your own. They're not really pushing you. So it's going to be rough changing that stuff.
It's called growing up.
Yeah,
you'll handle it fine, like so many other kids do. You know, a lot of people talk to opposing coaches and wrestlers. They feel like you've been like a college wrestler already. The last few years here, you've been so dominant. Has it been difficult to stay sharp when you're not getting? I know you go to some great tournaments, but not, maybe match in and match out, not getting the competition that is equal to yours.
I have one goal, and that's just to win. Go out on the mat knowing I can beat the kid and just wrestle to win and don't stop wrestling. And I feel like if I have that goal and I'm willing to do anything to win, like, everything I've been working for, everything that I trained for, and, like, in the wrestling room when I'm working my technique, I make sure everything's perfect. Even when it's, like a lazy practice, we're all just, like, playing dodgeball in the beginning, and then he says, all right, drill for a little bit. I'm making sure I'm going through the motions, making sure my technique's right, so when it comes to match time, it, like, I really don't have to worry about that because it's all, like,
second nature.
It's all, like, second nature and muscle memory to me, so it's easy, I guess. So
talk about your decision to go to Ohio State. Obviously, right now they're on top of the college wrestling world. They won the NCAA tournament this year, and you're going to go in to a great program with the great wrestlers in that room. What are your goals freshman year? Do you think you may redshirt, or you're going to jump right in? Do you have any idea what's going to happen down there?
I have a little bit of an idea. Coach Ryan and Jaggers and Roselli, they all talked to me about kind of going there, redshirting, doing a few tournaments, and kind of like trying to get stronger and bigger for, like, if I'm going to wrestle 184 or if I'm going to wrestle 174. I'm not too sure about that yet, but I think most likely I'm going to redshirt because they have, at 184 and 174, they have Mark Martin and Kenny Cords. They're going to be juniors, I mean seniors next year, so
right.
I'll redshirt my freshman year. Then after they leave, I'll move in this lineup, hopefully ready to go and win some national titles. So I'm just looking forward to getting in the wrestling room and training with some of those guys and kind of getting better. And I already know when I get there, I'm not going to get a takedown for about like maybe a month or two. So that's going to be a little bit frustrating and like humbling, I guess. So I'm just ready to get in.
That's how you learn, right?
Yeah, that's how you learn.
So what is the schedule for you now? What tournaments and what competitions are you going to take part in between now and the time you go away to school?
Right now, I'm just kind of lifting, taking a little break off the mat, and trying to get my body healthy. But May 5th, or the weekend of that, or whatever it is, I have Junior Feelers, which is in Las Vegas, and I get to watch like guys like Jordan Burroughs, and if they're competing, David Taylor, all those guys, because they're competing as well. And then I'm going to try to, like, make the junior world team if I possibly could at the U.S. Open and the World Trials, which are in Wisconsin, Madison. So right now I'm just kind of taking a break, lifting, and then hopefully next week get back on the mat and start training again and kind of get ready for it.
Well, Myles, it's been a pleasure to watch you wrestle. You learn something new and see something more amazing every time you take the mat. So it's been a lot of fun. And we're proud to have you as a two-time winner of the Varsity Sports Network upper weight wrestler of the year, really, in all reality, wrestler of the year. And we wish you nothing but success, and we look forward to hearing how you do as you go down the road to college and beyond. We'll want to compete maybe for a spot in the Olympics one day, who knows, and then probably end up coaching in the sport for a long time. So congratulations, and the best of luck to you.
Thank you.